I love democracy. I love the Republic.
The main thing is to protect these characters, make sure that they still continue to live in the way that you created them, and that the universe of Star Wars continues to grow.
Executive producer and president of Lucasfilm, Kathleen Kennedy! Executive producer!
So I thought about making this video for a while, and I've decided since Celebration last weekend to do it. It was a dumpster fire. Kathleen Kennedy did everything wrong. She announced movies she wasn't allowed to announce. She had the Acolyte crew up there when they weren't supposed to be there because of the lawsuit and Disney's confusion over what the hell they're doing. And it looks to me that Bob Iger has finally come to a point where he and the board are going to have to sit down and figure out what they're going to do with Kathleen Kennedy. Now, she's been told she has to see him face to face again and bring the fan reaction data, which is probably what people thought of the Ahsoka trailer, yada, yada, yada. They're not too happy with each other. But I don't think Bob Iger's been happy with Kathleen for a long, long time, despite the fanboys thinking the opposite. And let me explain something. Kathleen could have left, or could leave, could have left, with her dignity intact, with a nice golden parachute. But she's basically daring him to fire her, a la Victoria Alonso. You notice that Victoria Alonso's crying suddenly disappeared, right? This has been a long time coming, okay? Kathleen Kennedy has been in charge of Lucasfilm now for a little over 10 years. We're in April of 2023, and she's been in charge of Lucasfilm for about 10 years and 6 months, and it has not been a mostly good time, despite what her supporters think, and now she's getting razzed by the trades, publications, Variety, THR, Matt Bellany at Puck went after her, very scathing, sarcastic commentary about her vaunted Rey movie. Variety, in fact, giving a wink, wink, nudge, nudge to anything she's said is happening. Okay. Again, not too long ago, Bob Iger said, we are going to take a very close look at any Star Wars movie that we're going to go into and actually do active development with. None of these movies are greenlit. Okay, this is the board with all the December 2020 shows and movies announced. And it's an eraser board. It's a dry eraser board. Kennedy has done nothing but cause chaos. She's caused strife among the fans. Now she's causing infighting, we believe, among the fans directly. And to me, it looks like she wants to burn everything to the ground on the way out the door. Okay. And why? Well, look, if Bob Iger shows her the numbers, it's going to be hard to argue with that. She is a person who can't accept that what she did and what she created was just unsuccessful. She can't accept the fact that she's not the vaunted producer that people heralded her to be. She is not a glass ceiling breaker. There have been women ever since the dawn of movie making that have run their own studios. Okay, so she's not a glass ceiling breaker. But she's hanging on. It's as if she doesn't want to leave. She knows they're going to kick her out. And now she's basically at Celebration. She was daring Bob Iger to do exactly that. Fire me. Now, Bob Iger has been giving her a chance to behave herself, a chance to act like a professional and an adult, and she is not. From storming around the stage at Celebration, demanding her Ray movie be made, daring Iger to cancel it, to dragging out a very troubled, very mysterious production, The Acolyte, to show people they're doing something. You know, look, I've got the actual complaint now. It cost me $16. Let me tell you something. When I looked at that and then looked at Lucasfilm's defense, there's nothing to this show. It is a glorified sizzle reel. If you look at what McCarthy has said, it is a glorified sizzle reel. Okay. And this is the legacy of Kathleen Kennedy. And she's causing suffering in her own company. The people there that don't want her there, want her gone, are suffering. Disney's suffering. Catastrophic money losses because of her. And the fans are suffering. Her cast, the people that she's cast in these shows, are suffering because her incompetence in hiring directors, Rian Johnson, her incompetence in not knowing what Star Wars is about, is causing this. And yet she thinks she's right. She has absolutely no realistic idea of what's going on around her. And apparently no one close to her has the balls, Frank, to tell her, Kathy, it's time to retire. It's time to let it go. Let someone else fix what's wrong with the thing. Okay? You know, and this is the crux of the problem, okay? It's her.
Do it.
The fleet has moved out of light speed and we're preparing to...
You have failed me for the last time, Admiral.
And, I mean, look at this. Defiant resting bitch face. Which is there something wrong with her? You know, here's the deal. Kathleen Kennedy is acting out in a very weird way. You know, not following up with where the Acolyte contracts are as far as Disney's right to see them. Ignoring directives from the bosses. Daring them to fire her. This is very weird, juvenile behavior for someone who has got decades of professional work in Hollywood. And this is unhealthy behavior. Okay. And I look at her husband, Frank Marshall, and I want to ask him, why are you allowing your wife to behave this way? Why? Look, Kathy, it's time to retire. Please, for your own sake, please, just tell Bob you're sorry and you're going to leave quietly. Now you've got another face-to-face with him, and you may end up, I mean, I give him a 35% chance of cutting her off at the knees now because of what she's been doing. This is out of control behavior for someone of her responsibility. And she's left Lucasfilm without a leader. She's done everything she could to, monopolize the time other people had to show their wares to the public at Celebration. She's gone over overboard and subtly attacking and elbowing aside Jon Favreau, who was hired to fix what she broke. And yet she insists she wants to stay for another 5 years. She wants it. Why? This is a spoiled brat syndrome? Is it the juvenile idea and the catastrophically psycho idea of if I can't have it, no one can? I mean, what is this about? Because it doesn't make any sense. Anybody realistically would have said, okay, all right, boss. I'll take the agreement, I'll go. But why is she flailing? You know, when she did those announcements and, you know, everybody that has a brain rolled their eyes and was asking, oh my God, did I roll my eyes out loud? Like Matt Bellany did. They know this. None of this stuff is going to happen because there are things going, rumors going on in Hollywood that are not privy to us lay people, us fans. There's probably stuff being said about her behind her back, her poor management, her poor creative ability, and her poor professionalism that came out at Celebration, okay? No one feels sorry for her anymore. She's not being protected by the trades, and she's making it worse for herself. And yet, she persists. Okay, do I feel sorry for her? No. She did this to herself, and that's the truth, okay? And I can't imagine, this is called self-immolation. She's literally imploding in front of everybody right now. And it doesn't help her connection to Leslie Headland, who's imploding too. Because look, I read that lawsuit. They're fucked, okay? It's not Disney that's being called to the carpet. It's Kathleen Kennedy and Leslie Headland and Lucasfilm and Blue Stocking. That's it. They're the ones that are in trouble. And when Iger said to her, reach a settlement with McCarthy or else, you know, and I'm not sure if the woman striding around psychotically on stage at Celebration has any idea how to do that. Okay? I don't think she's capable of it. And it makes me sad for Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni and everybody at Lucasfilm who want to do right by Star Wars. And it makes me sad for Harrison Ford. It makes me sad for James Mangold, who should not be connected to this witch. It makes me sad for the fans. Because Kathy Kennedy's presence, even her just being there in silence, is enough to make people cringe. But the fact that she acted out in such a brazen, fuck you manner to everybody is causing catastrophic harm to Disney itself, not just to Lucasfilm, okay? And handling her with kid gloves anymore is just not going to work. And I'm going to say this. If the rags are now turning on her, that she doesn't have any allies, all right? That behavior of hers at Celebration, she made herself an island of absolute disdain, okay? She has done this to herself, okay? And she has no one to blame but herself. If she had done what Iger wanted her to do, which is do the Celebration the way she was supposed to, which was about her history and all the great things that she did. We wouldn't be, the fandom wouldn't be as upset. Disney wouldn't be getting fucked over again, etc. But She didn't. She sat there, the mouse waving its finger at the eagle as the eagle sweeping in to get it. Middle finger salute. Okay, to the bosses, I dare you to fire me. And I honestly don't think that Bob Iger can afford not to. Okay? You know, come up with some idea to get her out of Lucasfilm. You know, make it so she can go to cons with Andy and everything else. And there you go. I'm going to add this. She actually told Iger, I don't want to do this celebration of me at Celebration because people will think I'm leaving. And I don't want to leave. And Iger said, I don't care. You are leaving. Okay. You know, if Iger goes, she's done. Because whoever steps in as CEO will probably be somebody that Nelson Peltz puts in charge. And they're going to fire her ass. Okay. She doesn't realize that it's not Iger she's defying. She has no concept of the power that sits behind him. All right. Absolutely no idea how powerful these investors truly are. They're the ones that pull the string, not Bob Iger. He's doing what they've asked him to. And all she has to do, all she had to do, was quietly take her celebrated leave and go. And instead we've got this defiant psycho bitch at Celebration torpedoing Ahsoka, causing a rift in the fandom, and telling the Disney execs that are above her head to fuck off. You know, Kathy, get a grip, get a hold of yourself, because it's going to end up coming back, okay, on you. Whatever you put out in the universe comes back. And honey, I'm telling you, you've opened up a Pandora's box of trouble for yourself. And to the fans, stop despairing. You're watching a woman spinning out of control. You're watching a delusional woman imploding in front of your face. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.